Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Linda. So today I want to talk about aeronautical engineering. I want just to give my honest opinion about it, the level of difficulty, maybe as compared to other courses, but this is going to be a complete honest view from me personally, from me. If there's someone out there who's doing aeronautical and watching and they feel different, it's okay because we feel different about different things, especially when coming to academics. The level of difficulty is not the same for all of us, okay? So this is where we start. If I was in another country, maybe aeronautical engineering would be a common thing to do. But then since I'm in Africa, South Africa to be specific, this course is not so commonly known. People don't know about it. Every time when you tell someone that you are doing aeronautical, we have to explain first what is that. But then if you tell them that I'm doing teaching, I'm doing chemical engineering, I'm doing mechanical engineering, I am doing construction, what, it all sounds familiar to their ears. Yeah, it all sounds familiar, so they don't get confused as to what you are doing, what you're gonna be. So they kind of have an idea. When you're telling them that I'm doing chemical engineering, they kind of have an idea of what you are doing and what are your possibilities of being something. Yeah, okay. That is why the first thing that you should know that aeronautical engineering is not so commonly known. Because I know that here in South Africa, I think only VET it's offering it. I think UP also has it, but then the one that UP is having is kind of different from the one that we're having. I don't know the full story, but then our lecturer once told us that I don't understand. I'm trying to find the correct words to say it, but then our lecturer was like, it's kind of VET alone that is offering the kind of the real deal of aeronautical engineering. I hope I'm not offending anyone who's doing aeronautical at UP, but then yeah, that's what I know. So aeronautical, you know now that it's not so commonly known. People don't want it. Yes, to first start with the honest views that people don't want it. People don't want to do aeronautical. Even the ones that register for it for 2 years or for a year, they change. They go to other fields. They're like, no, I don't want to do this anymore. I don't know if sometimes they say that because it is difficult. Sometimes they say that the job opportunities, they are kind of slacking. They are not much of job opportunities in this field, which I don't really find it true in my honest view. I don't really find it true that if you're doing aeronautical, you're never gonna be employed. Of course, you cannot be expected to design an aircraft from start to end just because you're having an aeronautical degree. You gotta specialize in something. Okay, and the fact that you're an engineer, there are a lot of things that you can do other than just aeroplanes. You can do aerodynamics of cars, right? Yeah, you can do that. So yeah, about the job opportunities is that, yeah, people are saying that there are no job opportunities. I'm not sure if this is based on the factual, on factual things, or it's just based on how somebody feels. But according to me, I feel like it's not true that there are no jobs if you're doing aeronautical. And the difficulty part of it. This one, it can be because of the mindset, right? Maybe when people think of an aircraft, they're like, what, an entire aircraft? There's no way that I'm gonna study that. And they feel like it's difficult. But then that's not really, can be a big reason why somebody doesn't want to do it. Yes, in my class last year, we were less than 30, and you can tell that people don't want to do it. We were less than 30, not because they only accept less than 30. We were less than 30 because people don't want to come in aero. People don't want to come in aero. In campus, when you are meeting somebody and you get to a conversation and to a point whereby you gotta know which course you are both doing, and you mention that we're doing aeronautical, they'll be like, yo. Yo, they get scared. I'm like, hey. I remember last year I also had this pressure that, you know what, I want to change. I don't want aero anymore, because I felt like everyone was changing to mechanical and industrial and other fields. And I felt like, oh, nobody wants this thing. Who am I to face it? I don't want it also. But then I was told that when I went to consult with one of the lecturers, and he told me that, you know what? Yes, it's okay. This is normal for people to run away from aero. It is difficult. He did say that aeronautical, it is difficult. He didn't tell me as compared to what, but then he did state that it is difficult. So it is normal for people to run away from it. It is normal for people to fail it several times before they can finally conquer the edge. Yeah, if you are from vets, we normally say when you get your degree, we say that you have conquered the edge, the vets edge. So if you are staying in it, be ready for whatever challenge that you're going to face. But then if you are running away from it, you will never know if you were going to master it or not. So just stay in it, just stay in it. And he told me that just because you are doing aeronautical doesn't mean that you are going to work on aeroplanes. You did fluid mechanics, right? You can still work on projects related to fluids, okay? You can still work on such you can do manufacturing, right? Manufacturing of other parts, be it a car, be it an aircraft. So it's not like you are limited to just aircrafts, okay? And then another thing that I felt like is that I wish maybe in school, if we had some course that is having the basics of aviation, let me say, that is having basics of aircrafts, aeroplanes, maybe it was going to be a little bit simple, because there are technical subjects at school, but then they are more of mechanical. There is fitting, and then there's mechanical fitting. At my high school, there's mechanical fitting, and then the technical drawing that we are doing, it has nothing to do with aircraft. It is more of mechanical than aeronautical. And then there is a construction. And then see the people who are going to go to civil and stuff, they're having kind of the basics. And then there is there's civil, which the construction is civil. And then there's electrical. I did electrical, so the people going to the electrical field, they are having also the basics. But then for us who are going to aeronautical, well, we're having the basics of other fields. We're having the basics of mechanical, electrical, construction, or civil engineering. But then for us, we have nothing from high school. So when you get there, I feel like you start too much from scratch. And then depending on where you are coming from, let me tell you, you have never been to an aircraft before. You have never been next to an aircraft before. But you are doing aeronautical. And then there's this somebody who's kind of rich, and they know a whole lot about aeroplanes. So when you are just there, you have no idea. And maybe when the lecturer is making an example that when you are in an aircraft and then it is cruising, and then you feel something, and you're like, okay, I've never been in an aircraft before, so I don't know what you guys are talking about. If you're talking about feelings, I have no idea, because I have never been into an aircraft before. So that is also one thing that makes it to be difficult. And then in terms of the content wise, the content for me, I think it gets very difficult, because you have no idea. You have no idea. You don't have the basics at all. When you get there, you are expected to know the basics, to grasp the content of the basics and the hardcore stuff. At the same time, you can imagine how demanding that is. That's why so maybe people don't want it. Obviously, it's not like somebody just wakes up today and say aeronautical is difficult. It's because maybe they've done it, they've tried it, or somebody is always complaining about it, so they conclude that that course, it's not for human beings, it's for some other smarty pants. Yes, so those are my honest view. If you feel like aeronautical is easier for you or whatever, yeah, that is good. We are different, but then according to me, one word, difficult, very difficult. But then for it being difficult doesn't mean that it's undoable or not doable or not possible to pass it. I think it is possible to pass it. Given enough chances to do it, you can do it. You can do it if you're given enough chances to do it. Yeah, you can do it. I've never done other fields. I've never been into other fields. I never did education. I never did art. I never did mechanical engineering. I never did chemical. I never did electrical. I have no idea on how difficult the other fields are, and I cannot compare them with aeronautical. So, but then yes, especially with engineering courses, I cannot compare much aeronautical with it because I have no idea. But then just the fact that there's engineering in it, it feels like all these courses are difficult. But obviously, I cannot say, forgive me if you're doing history, this just came into my mind, but I cannot say aeronautical is better than history. They are just not in the same league, not in the same industry, not in the same field, right? So I cannot compare much on them. I cannot compare engineering with arts. I cannot, yes, the level of difficulty. Come on, guys, let's be honest. I don't want to get arrested, but then let's be honest, man. Arts, yes, arts is arts, and aero is aero. Aero is aero. Engineering is engineering. They are having their own level of difficulty. So comparing these engineering fields alone, I have friends doing mechanical engineering, and they sometimes tell me that seems like your aero is too difficult. So I don't know, because we do talk on the stuff that we are doing. We do compare the courses that we are taking. Sometimes some of the courses, they are common. And then, yeah, some of them, they're not common. Some of them, they're just specific for us, aero. Some of them, they're specific for them, mechanical. But sometimes they complain that it seems like yours is more difficult. But I also feel like theirs is more difficult. Yeah, if you want to do aeronautical, I think you should go for it. Yes, go for it and be ready for all the challenges. Be ready for emotions. if your heart is not having enough room for emotions, hey, you gonna suffer. We don't want people committing suicide, hey? We're also facing very hard times here. We're struggling, we're going through hell, but we are staying in it, okay? We are staying in it no matter what. So if you wanna do aero, yeah, just come to it, have the heart for it. And then, since it is not so common and there are very few people who are doing aero, that can be the factor that will also contribute towards you being scared of it. Yeah, so, well, that was just my honest view on how aeronautical is, how I find it. I find it very difficult, but it is interesting at the same time. It is very nice to do something that most people don't want to do. It is very nice to go for something that most people don't want to go for it. And when you're like, I'm going for it. Yes, I'm going for it. And then when you get there, you get chowed, but you still stay in it. You're like, no, I'm staying in it. It's okay. I'm getting chowed like the dumbest person in the world, but I'm staying in it because it's interesting and I love it. I cannot go back. You can go back, but then for me, I don't consider going back as an option. It's not part of the options that I can take at this point. So if you're gonna come to Eru, yes, come to it, have the heart for it, have the heart, have a big room for emotion, have a big room for disappointment, have a big room for sleepless nights. Even in other fields, I believe that you're still gonna have to face all the difficulties. But I think when you're comparing it to aero is kind of... Hey, guys, have a great day. Goodbye.